Welcome viewers to Wisdom 101 with me, your host, Pastor Wesley Manasseh. I want you to sit back wherever you're catching this from. If you're working, I want you to put up the volume. If you're catching this live on social platform, whether it's Facebook, YouTube, just share this, create a watch party. We're going to have an awesome time in Wisdom 101. Our program is called Wisdom 101 because we look at wisdom. Wisdom 101 gives you a platform where you have a one-on-one with wisdom. And I'm excited every time this program comes on, because imagine some of the people in this world have never had access with the wisest people in the whole world. And my life has been built around wisdom. I've spent many days with Solomon. I've spent days with Joseph. I spent days with Daniel. I spent days continuously with our Lord Jesus Christ, with Apostle Paul. Our program is called Wisdom 101 because it gives you a platform where you can have a one-on-one with wisdom. I live in the world of wisdom. Wisdom is my passion. I am so driven by wisdom that I would love everyone to fall in love with wisdom. 2021 has come. Everyone is excited. Oh, 2021 is my year. Oh, this is going to happen. People are excited and they're happy. But ask the question, how many people have wisdom for 2021? If you followed the programs that we've been having, we've been talking about wisdom for success in 2021. Why do you need wisdom for you to be successful? Wisdom is the one that determines success. Now, you must understand there are a lot of definitions people have given to wisdom, depending upon their interpretation, their understanding, and their exposure. But there is an interpretation that God has given me that I've fallen in love with. Wisdom is a way of seeing. Wisdom is the lens that you use to see things. Meaning, wisdom is what makes you interpret things the way you interpret things. Wisdom is more like the basis of your reasoning, where your perception comes from. A lot of people don't have wisdom on how to make this year a success. And that's why this program is coming to you live right now, so that you can be able to get understanding on what will it take for me to be a success in 2021. A lot of people don't know this, but imagine, God is more interested and is more willing for you to succeed than you know. A lot of people have been ignorant about the heart of God when it comes to success. A lot of people think, oh, succeeding is just something that will happen along the way. No. The one who created you, the one who made you, had success on his heart. He wanted the product he made to fulfill its purpose. So, every time you come in contact with Wisdom 101, we give you a one-on-one with wisdom, but that wisdom is not wisdom limited to this world. A lot of people don't know that we are in this world, but we are not of this world. Our original country where we came from is heaven. And if you are going to be successful on the earth, you need to understand how we ran from where we come from. You need to have the laws. You need to have the culture. You need to have the habits. You need to have the principles. You need to have the way we do things in heaven. And as long as you don't have that wisdom, you cannot be a success. And that's why on our previous program, I went into Isaiah 46 verse 10 and 11. Isaiah 46 verse 10 and 11 gives us a pattern and a model of how God works. God says, I make known the end from the beginning. He says, from ancient times, I have said what I have planned, what I want to do, it will come to pass. So God always starts with the end in mind. 2021 has come. The question is, do you have wisdom on an end? Has God revealed to you an end? Do you have a goal? Do you have a vision? Do you have a dream? Do you have a target of things that God has put on your heart? Do you have a revelation of what God is showing you, what you are supposed to accomplish, what you are supposed to do? If you don't, your year has not begun. Your year only begins when you see the end. And that's why I'm saying that the country where we come from, which is heaven, there is a way things are done. And God operates always with the end in mind. God does not start anything that he does not finish. Every human being on the earth right now, imagine God already finished them. That's why they actually started. God does not allow conception to take place except he has already finished someone. Let me read you a scripture in Jeremiah. You see, this book is our constitution. This book is our manual. This book is our guide for successful living. A lot of people think the Bible is a religious book. Please hear me. This book is the constitution that shows us what we are entitled to and how to function and how to best maximize. So I want you to follow what Jeremiah 1 verse 5 says. Jeremiah chapter 1 verse 5. Before I formed you in the womb, I knew you. Before you were born, I set you apart. I appointed you as a prophet to the nations. Listen to that. Before the beginning, it says, before I formed you in the womb, meaning before conception took place, there was a plan, there was a purpose, there was a mandate, there was a prophet that was supposed to come and manifest to the nations. So God already had finished Jeremiah's life before he began him. Now, Jeremiah is one example, but do you know that this is true about every other person? Let me read you something in Galatians. And you see, if you don't read this Bible, you'll be very, very limited. Galatians chapter 1. I want you to see something more. I love, this is now Apostle Paul in the New Testament. Because a lot of people right now are fighting over all the New Testament. So every time you read the Bible, you have to show them something in the New. Galatians chapter 1. Let me start it from verse 13. Let me start from verse 11 for content and background. I want you to know, brothers and sisters, that the gospel I preached is not of human origin. Verse 12. I did not receive it from any man, nor was I taught it. Rather, I received it by revelation from Jesus Christ. For you have heard of my previous way of life in Judaism, how intensely I persecuted the church and tried to destroy it. Verse 14, I was advancing in Judaism beyond many of my own age, my people, and I was extremely zealous for the traditions of my elders. Traditions have limited a lot of people, and I might touch that today. But when God, listen to this, Galatians chapter 1 verse 15, but when God, who set me apart from my mother's womb, called me by his grace and was pleased to reveal his son in me so that I might preach him among the Gentiles, my immediate response was not to consult any human being. Listen to that again. I want you to follow this. Galatians 1 verse 15. But when God, who set me apart from my mother's womb, imagine when conception was taking place, I don't know how you were born. A lot of people are watching this right now from different backgrounds. Some were born in a family, some were born out of wedlock, some were born where there was no lock at all. Some were born out of abuse, some were born out of rape. Some, it was a mistake. Young guys and boys were playing and a pregnancy came in. A lot of things might have been said on how you were conceived. Man might have his own story. I'm telling you the story of God. Because I've been telling people 2021 is going to be the most successful, the most awesome, amazing year ever. And that's why we are having this one-on-one on wisdom. So that when you have understanding, there is going to be depth, there's going to be confidence. You're not going to have low self-esteem. You're not going to battle with inferiority, identity, complex issues. Because if you see the things that limit people in the path to success is identity. When you don't know who you are, when you don't know where you're coming from, when you don't know why you are here, guess what? You have no confidence. You have no drive. There's no meaning to your waking up. But listen to what this man says. From the womb, God set me apart. He says, but when God, who set me apart from my mother's womb and called me by his grace, he was pleased to reveal. The whole of last year, I was telling people, except something is revealed to you, it doesn't belong to you. What you're hearing right now, it has to become a revelation. You have to know to say, I was born because there was an end. There is something God finished that I was born to start. Conception does not take place. God does not allow conception to take place except a purpose, a time for a purpose has come. And the deliverer, the savior, the leader, the visionary, the dreamer, the person who's supposed to run that, their time has come. So when conception takes place, listen to what that conception is announcing. Time has come for a move, for a wave. Time has come for a particular dispensation. When I was conceived, God was setting a dispensation for wisdom to enter the earth. When I was conceived, God was setting a dispensation of a man who was going to bring the kingdom of God down. God would not have allowed conception to take place except it was time. And please hear me. You might not have understood why you are alive up to now. Please get what God is telling you right now. God would never allow conception to take place except there is a purpose, there is a mandate. If a Moses is born, there is an Israel that needs to be delivered from Egypt. If there is a David that is born, hear me, there is a nation called Israel that needs to be established because a nation has just been born. Saul is just the first king of Israel. Israel is a new nation. It's just being formed. So it needs a warrior king because a lot of nations will try to squash it, will try to destroy it, and will try to bring it out of the scene. So they need a warrior king. So David is born. If Solomon is going to be born, a new kingdom has been born. This kingdom, David the father has fought all the battles. So the kingdom is now established. The kingdom now has land. The kingdom has now wealth. But guess what? It doesn't have structure. It doesn't have systems. So a Solomon will be born. And why is Solomon born? Solomon is born to create a structure. Solomon is born to build industry. Solomon is born to establish people. Solomon is born to set systems in place. You were not just born. Please hear me. There is a purpose and there is a mandate over your life. You were born in a specific time as this. Don't be, you see, COVID and the coronavirus is messing people up. But they don't know that they were born specifically to be in this time of COVID. Because there is a disposition, there is something God deposited. There is something God put in you that is supposed to deal with corona. Why were you born in this time? Why was David born in the time of Goliath? Because what was to bring down Goliath was in David. Why was Samson born in the time when lions would attack people and kill people? It was because in Samson, what kills lions was in him. Why was Apostle Paul born at the time when the church was being birthed and the church was persecuted? Don't forget what we read in Galatians 1. He was part of the persecutors of the church. The church was just being born and it needed a zealous, a driven person. And Apostle Paul was given the baton to take the church outside the walls of Jerusalem. And I think that's where even the error about the gospel that Paul preached comes to. Because imagine, Apostle Paul was called by God to bring the gospel outside Israel, outside Jerusalem, outside the Jewish custom, Jewish culture. And a lot of misunderstanding have come to what Apostle Paul preached, because Apostle Paul kept trying to explain, to say, I'm an apostle sent to the Gentiles. And he says, I have this revelation. What is the revelation he had? The revelation that he had is that we are one. There is no Jew, there is no Gentile. There is no Greek. There is no male, there is no female. When Christ died on the cross, he paid the price. He brought us that we were far. By the blood, he brought us near. We have now been reconciled. We have now become new creatures in Christ Jesus. You see, all that falls in place. And that's why there's a lot of misunderstanding about what Paul preached. Because Paul was trying to explain to people that, listen, Christ died. And when he died, he gave access. People have taken what he was trying to explain as his gospel. That was not the gospel. Please hear what you're hearing. Because this has been going along in the church for a long time. The gospel of grace, the gospel of Christ, the gospel of this and that. There's only one gospel, the gospel of the kingdom of God. That's the gospel that our Lord Jesus preached. That's the gospel that Apostle Paul preached. And until the church goes into the kingdom, we don't have success. A lot of people are talking about the Lord Jesus is coming. Have you heard what Jesus himself said about when he was going to come? When this gospel of the kingdom is preached in all nations. We haven't even started preaching the gospel of the kingdom. We are still arguing about what the gospel is. Why am I telling you this? This is now my assignment. My mandate is to bring wisdom, bring understanding. Don't forget, wisdom is a way of seeing. So there is a way I see scripture. There is a way that I see what a man taught, what his assignment was, that another man would never see. Why? That's my assignment. That is what I'm anointed for. That is what I'm wired up for. I was born at this time to bring understanding to the body of Christ, to bring understanding to the world, to say, listen, if you can see correctly, you will think right and you do the right thing. Why isn't the church preaching the kingdom of God today? Why aren't believers, why aren't disciples running with the mandate of the kingdom today? Guess what? Who has that revelation? Who has seen what Christ wanted us to do? So, I want you to understand, what I'm sharing right now is deeply connected to my purpose. It's deeply connected to why I'm alive and why I'm doing what I'm doing right now. Guess what? There is what you were born for as well. I want you to hear this. There is what you were born for. And listen, don't be swallowed in this thing as if we are all born for the same thing. No. If you are a child of God, the mission is the same. Go out and make disciples of all men. That's our mission, if you're a disciple. The mission, if you are just a child of God, the mandate is the same for every child of God. Let us make man in our own image and in our own likeness, and let that man have dominion. Listen, let us make man. Genesis 1 verse 26. Because some of you are watching this and they say, sir, I hear what you're saying about a purpose and about a mandate, but I don't know my own. Where do I start from? I'm showing you to start from what is already on the ground. Yes, you can seek God, like now what happened to Apostle Paul, where God gives him now a distinct revelation. What do I mean by a distinct revelation? Paul is an apostle to the Gentiles. That is what was revealed to him by Jesus Christ. But what Christ has revealed to every disciple, every child of God, is Genesis 1:26. Let us make man in our own image and in our own likeness, and let them have dominion. What will be success for you in 2021? Are you dominating? Are you in charge? What will be success for you in 2021? Who's ruling? Who carries the influence in your sphere? In that area where you're functioning, who is the authority? Who is the influencer? I did, you see, there are a lot of things that I didn't know why God called me into. Like, for example, I have pushed wisdom, if you have followed me, I have pushed nothing but wisdom for the last over 15 years. This is now the 16th year. From 2005 up to date, I've pushed wisdom. 16 years in a row. God revealed to me wisdom was the highest value. Wisdom was the secret of secrets. Wisdom was the master key. Wisdom was the most important thing. God revealed to me wisdom was the principal thing. That's why I talk nothing but wisdom. But do you know that even if God revealed to me that this is the most important, the precious, this is the secret, this is the master key, I didn't understand until last year that it is by wisdom that kings reign. So imagine, God had started me on a journey. And yes, I've been talking about wisdom. I've been teaching wisdom. I've been talking about wisdom for success, wisdom for wealth. But do you know that last year, God opened me up to understand, to say, the purpose of wisdom is dominion. That's why Jesus had wisdom and he took over and he dominated his generation. Show me any man who was in charge. Show me any man who dominated. I'll show you wisdom around their life. You're watching this program. You're wondering, Lord, where am I supposed to start from? I'm showing you what the wisdom of God says. Genesis 1:26, that's where you start from. Let us make man in our own image and in our own likeness. And let this man have dominion. That's a general purpose for everyone. That's your beginning. You need to learn now in the school of dominion. How do I dominate? Then he says, verse 27, male and female he created them. Meaning there is nothing about gender. There is nothing about, oh, men are supposed to be entrepreneurs. Men are supposed to be industrious. Men are supposed to be pioneers. Men are supposed to lead. No, there's nothing like that. Male and female, he created them. Let us make man in our own image and in our own likeness. Listen, let them, not let him, let them. The world has been dominated by men because the Bible was not taught right. My God, I want you to listen. A lot of women, their purpose has been reduced to childbearing. Their purpose has been reduced to marriage. Their purpose has been reduced to raising children. Their purpose has been reduced. Now, listen, that is one of a function of a woman. That's not the purpose of a woman. The purpose of every human being is in Genesis 1, 26 to 28. Let us make man. What you were born for is to dominate. Pastor Manasseh, what am I supposed to dominate? What did he talk about? He says, dominate over the birds of the air. Have you seen the internet right now? That's the birds of the air. So the biggest billionaires right now are dominating the birds of the air. The problem when you're reading the Bible, if you don't have the lens of wisdom for revelation, guess what? You will hear only what he's saying. You will not hear why he's saying it. When the Bible was being written, the internet was not there, but God knew the internet would be there. I want you to hear what you're hearing. He says, man is supposed to dominate the birds of the air. Look at people who are dominating the airwaves. Look at radio, look at TV. Look at artificial intelligence right now. Look at clouds that are being formed to store data, to store. Look at the social world right now. Look at the tech companies right now. The people, look at the richest guys right now. They are dominating the air. It says, everything that is in the water. Look at most of the wells where they drill oil. Look at the plants, most of the plants where they drill oil from. Look at the land. He says, on everything on the earth, everything that moves on the earth. So whether you are controlling the waves, whether you are controlling what comes from the land, whether you are controlling what is in the land, man was created to dominate. Now, these are things, I might have a session, I think, where I need to break down birds of the air, everything that creeps and moves along the land and over the entire earth. Man was created to dominate. And don't forget what I'm saying, male and female. Then he said to them, Genesis 1 verse 28, be fruitful, meaning produce. What are you going to produce in 2021? Someone has produced coronavirus. What are you going to produce? What are you going to produce? Someone has produced DSTV. Someone has produced ShopRite. Someone has produced Hungry Lion. Or someone has produced the internet. Someone has produced Facebook. Someone has produced these social platforms. What are you going to produce? What am I talking about today? Your success is tied to you understanding that you are born for a purpose. There's no one born that doesn't have a purpose. Everyone born was born to do something. And I've shown you that. Everyone born from the womb, there was a purpose. There was an assignment. Your discovery of what you were born to do, to bring on the earth, that is what starts you in a school of success. You are catching this and you're in Lusaka and you'd love to meet with me, I would love to join you. I've been receiving a lot of complaints from people to say, you don't talk about your church and you don't share. Please, I'm the senior pastor, Barak Ministries, Goshen, headquarters, Lusaka. If you're in Lusaka, you want to fellowship with us, join us, 9:30. Goshen is mass media area, opposite football house, off Alikinkata Road, 9:30 to 11:30. Come and continue in this grace and in this wisdom. I am so excited. I don't want you to miss the next episode because we build from where we have left today. God bless you. Success is determined by the wisdom that you have. If you don't have wisdom, you cannot produce success. There is a wisdom that controls a home. There is a wisdom that governs a relationship. There is a wisdom that governs communication.
You see, it's not my people are destroyed because of lack of knowledge, because they didn't get knowledge. No! You rejected knowledge.